Hello, my dear students. I am Priyanka Bisht, your maths teacher. Today, I am going to teach you the topics before, after, and between numbers and comparing and arranging three-digit numbers. Children, you have already learned about three-digit numbers. So today, in three-digit numbers, we will learn about before numbers, between numbers, and after numbers. Before number means previous number. Before number means previous number. Children, when we count backward from the given number, we get before number. When we count backward from the given number, we get before number. Let us see some examples. Look at the numbers. To find out before number of 234, we have to count backward, and the very first number we get is 233. So here the number before 234 is 233. Let us see one more example. Here we have to find out the number before 499. So we have to count backward, and the very first number we get is 498. So the number before 499 is 498. Now let us learn after numbers. After number means next number. After number means next number. Students, when we count forward from the given number, we get after number. When we count forward from the given number, we get after number. Let's see some examples. Look at the numbers. To find out after number of 741, we have to count forward, and the number we get is 742. So here the number after 741 is 742. Let's have one more example. Here, to find out after number of 900, we have to count forward, and the number we get is 901. So here, the number after 900 is 901. Now let us learn about between numbers. Between numbers lie in the middle of two numbers. Between numbers lie in the middle of two numbers. Let us have some examples. Here, the number in between 100 and 102 is 101. Now look at the numbers. The number in between 225 and 227 is 226. Now let us solve some questions. Here some numbers are given, and we have to find out the after numbers and before numbers. Let us see the first number. The number is 843. Now, to find after number, what we are going to do? We are going to count forward. And the number we get is 844. Now, to find out before number, what we will do, children? We will count backward. And the number we get is 842. Now, next number is 599. To find out after number, we count forward. And the number we get is 600. And to find out before number, we count backward. So, the number we get is 598. Now, same for this number. What is the number? The number is 704. The number after 704 is 705. And the number before 704 is 703. Now, let us solve some between numbers. First, here we have numbers 406 and 408. So, what is the number in between? The number is 407. Next example, which two numbers are given? The numbers are 222 and 224. So, the number in between is 223. Next, third example, the number in between 924 and 926 is 925. Now, move on to the next topic, that is comparing and arranging three-digit numbers. Children, you have already learned how to compare two-digit numbers. Now, I will teach you how to compare three-digit numbers. So, to compare three-digit numbers, first, compare the digits in the hundreds place. If the digits in the hundreds place are equal, compare the digits in the tens place. If the digits in the tens place are equal, compare the digits in the ones place. So, to compare three-digit numbers, compare the hundreds. If equal, compare the tens. If equal, compare the ones. Children, remember this thing. The number that comes later while counting is greater. The number that comes later while counting is greater. Children, now let us understand this with some examples. Look at the numbers. The numbers are 247 and 623. We begin by comparing the digits in the hundreds place. That is 2 and 6. Here 6 is greater than 2. So the number 623 is greater than 247. The open side of the sign always points towards the greater number, and the closed side of the sign always points towards the smaller number. Now, let us try some more examples. Look at the numbers. Here, the numbers are 729 and 737. We begin by comparing the digits in the hundreds place, that is 7 and 7. The digits are the same here. So, now we compare the digits in the tens place, that is 2 and 3. Here, 3 is greater than 2. So, the number 737 is greater than 729. The open side of the sign always points towards the greater number, and the closed side of the sign always points towards the smaller number. Now, let us take one more example. The numbers are 879 and 879. So, here, first we will compare the digits in the hundreds place. That is 8 and 8. So, the digits are same here. Now, we compare the digits in the tens place, that is 7 and 7. Again, the digits are same. So, now we will compare the digits in the ones place, that is 9 and 9. Again, the digits are same. So, the number 879 is equal to 879. Here, we put equal to sign. It means both the numbers are equal. Now, let us move on to the next topic. That is smallest number. Children, please remember, while counting, the smallest number comes before the others. While counting, the smallest number comes before the others. Now, let us have some examples. Look at the numbers. The numbers are 234, 543, 125, and 676. So, here we have to find out the smallest number. First, we will compare the digits in the hundreds place. So, in 234, it is 2, in 543 it is 5, in 125 it is 1, and in 676 it is 6. So here 1 is smaller in all the digits, so 125 is the smallest number. Now, let us take one more example. The numbers are 376, 423, 300, and 567. We begin by comparing the digits in the hundreds place. In 376, it is 3. In 423, it is 4. In 300, it is 3.
and in 567 it is 5. So here 3 is smaller in all the digits, but you will see the number 376 and 300 both have 3 in their hundreds place. So now we will compare their tens digit. So in 376 it is 7 and in 300 it is 0. So 0 is smaller. So 300 is the smallest number. Now we will learn how to find out the largest number. Children, while counting, the largest number comes after the others. While counting, the largest number comes after the others. Now let us have some examples. The numbers are 621, 756, 102 and 112. So here we have to find out the largest number. Children, we will begin by comparing the digits in the hundreds place. So in 621 it is 6, in 756 it is 7, in 102 it is 1, and in 112 it is 1. So 7 is the largest digit in all the digits. So 756 is the largest number. Let us have one more example. Look at the numbers. The numbers are 368, 830, 870 and 800. And here we have to find out the largest number. So first we will compare the digits in the hundreds place. So in 368 it is 3, in 830 it is 8, in 870 it is 8, and in 800 it is 8. So you will see that the numbers 830, 870 and 800 have same number, that is 8, in their hundreds place. So now we will compare their tens digit. In 830 it is 3, in 870 it is 7, and in 800 it is 0. So here 7 is the largest digit among them. So 870 is the largest number. Now our next topic is arranging three digit numbers. Children, we can arrange the numbers in two ways. First, ascending order, and second, descending order. Now let us learn about ascending order. Ascending order means arranging the numbers from the smallest to the largest. Ascending order means arranging the numbers from the smallest to the largest. Children, now let us understand this with an example. Look at the numbers. The numbers are 644, 534, 243, 317 and 402. And we have to arrange these numbers in ascending order. Ascending order means from the smallest to the largest. So first we will compare the digits in the hundreds place.
So the order will be 2, then 3, then 4, then 5, and then 6. So in ascending order, how you will write these numbers? First, you will write the smallest number. So the smallest number is 243. Then you will write the next number greater than 243, that is 317. The next number greater than 317 is 402. The next number greater than 402 is 534. And in the last, you will write the largest number, that is 644. So, in this way, we have arranged the numbers in ascending order. Now, let us discuss about descending order. So, what is descending order? Descending order means arranging numbers from the largest to the smallest. Descending order means arranging numbers from the largest to the smallest. Now, children, let us solve this question. Look at the numbers. The numbers are 528, 749, 831, 644, and 263. So here you have to arrange the numbers in descending order. Descending order means from the largest to the smallest. So first we will compare the digits in the hundreds place. So the order will be 8, then 7, then 6, then 5, and then 2. So in descending order, how you will write these numbers? First you will write the greatest number. So here 831 is the greatest number. Then the next number smaller than 831 is 749. Then the next number smaller than 749 is 644. Then the next number smaller than 644 is 528. And in the last, you will write the smallest number, that is 263.